What you are about to see is not suitable for children. What's up everyone, Sag here, and today we're playing some more Marvel Snap, and I'm going to show you this absolutely disgusting deck that I put together. So, I call this deck Goblin on My Deck because it runs Green Goblin and Hobgoblin. So if you don't know, Green Goblin, 3 energy, negative 3 power. On reveal, your opponent gains control of this. Same with Hobgoblin, just 5, negative 8. This deck is absolutely disgusting. You could sort of call it a control deck, but it's more of like a butthead deck. Like, you just basically mess with your opponents, and it is very good at that, I will tell you what. The main premise of the deck is mostly putting Green Goblin and Hobgoblin onto their side, using Angela. You buff up Angela with Green Goblin, and then you can play more stuff there. You can use Debris, which is a really cool card, add a rock to each other location for both players. So you can use Debris to clog up their board as well. Use Armor to make sure they can't kill Green Goblin or the rocks. You have Mojo as well, because Mojo is like a little sneaky card. You can play it and then have one space left open for both players, and then last turn Debris, put 2 rocks there, and Mojo gets buffed up big. You use Storm to cut off locations. Like, it is just a really, really solid deck. But you know what makes the deck even better, and this is the truly disgusting part, is the hot location right now, Bar Sinister. When you play a card here, fill this location with copies of it. And what happens is when you play Green Goblin or Hobgoblin here, it will create 4 cards on your spot and then throw them all over to the other side, basically negating this entire location for the other player. So absolutely disgusting combo. It is really, really annoying and really good. So currently, I'm at 99 Galactic. I am literally 1 away from being infinite. So I really hope that we can get infinite in this episode. And I'm pretty sure that we'll be able to because of how disgusting this deck is. Goblin all over my deck, please. I love when they goblin on my deck. If you don't know, that's a play on words. Well, now that I've explained it, it sounds horrible. But yeah, this is completely degenerate. The deck works quite well without Bar Sinister, but with the inclusion of Bar Sinister, it is very, very much annoying. And now Muffin is crying. Muffin is crying so much because of this. I would too, realistically. Every time I see this, I cry. Oh my god. I mean, it might happen here. So many people are doing this, I feel like. Oh, he's already fucked up. He's already done for. Yeah, this combo is really annoying. See, so that happens. We get 4. Oh, so at 1, I forgot. 1 Green Goblin will actually stay on your side, but at that point, it doesn't really matter. When they have this location completely locked out. Yeah, and now it's kind of like, what do they do here? So, it's kind of funny. We could play Debris as well on Bar Sinister. But maybe we should play a couple more things first. I think Mojo here is probably pretty good. He's got the Killmonger. He buffs up his Green Goblins. He definitely needed that. I probably just play Blue Marvel here. Right? I could play Hobgoblin, but honestly, it's not that good. Probably just Blue Marvel here. I'm gonna snap. I mean, like, I don't know how he's gonna beat me, but I doubt it. I have Shang-Chi in the deck too. If I pull it, I can just kill monster. Yeah. I have a feeling the way to get to infinite is going to be that 10 times in a row. I'm definitely feeling it. But yeah, this deck is disgusting, and Bar Sinister just makes it all the worse. I just got Debris too, and I just threw it into the deck because I felt like it'd be pretty good. Sometimes I throw Debris on Bar Sinister, and I absolutely fuck myself. I do that way too much. Ooh, Nightcrawler. So Nightcrawler on Bar Sinister is pretty cool. This is also really good protection. So now they can't Green Goblin me. And I can do it whenever I want. Hope I get it here. I did not. I don't really like Debris. Maybe I Debris here. Like, it's actually pretty good because we put a rock on Bar Sinister for them. I have a feeling I'm not gonna get, what's it called? Green Goblin. I mean, I could always Hobgob them as well. Gob on my Hob. Hob on my Gob? What do we want to do here? We could Angela Armor. Probably here. So he is putting something on Bar Sinister now. Cannot get rid of that rock. Ooh, he put Hood there. Tripling up on the Patriot. I mean, I'm probably going to put my Blue Marvel there. Oh, I can't because of Dream Dimension. That's a little awkward. Can't do Doctor Doom either. I could just kill his Cyclops, but I probably want to wait, don't I? No, let's just do it now. Well, he flips first. Yeah, he flips first. I'm actually going to do it. Because if he put something big there... Okay, no, he didn't. Mystique. I'm fine with that. Oh, I just noticed the rocks actually help him out quite a bit. Dr. Doom. Yeah, I guess the rocks do help him out quite a bit here. And now that I think about it, I don't have enough space to do anything because of Dr. Doom. That's actually pretty bad. If he has Onslaught, I think I lose. He has Onslaught. How much is that? He'll get another... Only another two, right? Another two here, two here, two here. If I play Blue Marvel, I think I'm okay. I think I'm okay. Oh, he's got a Blue Marvel. Oopsie. Oh my god. Oh, I didn't think about Demon. Oh yeah, that's my bad. I didn't even think about Demon. Demon is a 115. Okay, I played that a little weird. I'll admit it. The Nightcrawler play, a little awkward. I didn't have enough room. My Debris. Oh, I see what you're doing. You dirty dog. Isle of Silence. Okay, probably put, put Angela there. No, we'll just put Angela here. Scorpion, nasty. He's probably also running Hobgoblin too, if that's the case. Yeah, Green Gob here. He's really nice because you get the two from Angela and then it switches sides. You're free to put even more stuff here. And it clogs up their board. Now, if they're playing a destroy deck, that's why we have armor to... Like, I would probably play armor here to protect... We have to protect that Green Goblin and our Angela. However, I really like JJ... I think JJ on Isle of Silence is pretty good. It's only 7 power. Oh my god, he has his own JJ. Good blue marble. Probably what I have to do. It doesn't look like he's playing any destroying, like he doesn't have Carnage or Deathlock or anything. I have no idea he could. I feel like that's probably a good thing with so many people running Green Goblin. Just like run Deathlock or Carnage or what's the other one? Venom. He's blue marble too? Dude, what is going on right now? How am I supposed to win? Oh, actually I can kill his JJ. That's pretty good. We do this, and then we probably... What is he going to try to win on? I'll probably just play armor here. He flips first too, so if he does play something big here, I'm pretty confident, I think. He could be playing Dr. Doom. If he's playing Dr. Doom, does he beat me? No. If he plays Ultron, does he beat me? I don't think so. Ultron in the middle, it would tie. Ooh. I don't think he's playing Ultron, though. Who the fuck plays Ultron in this day and age? I've seen like one Ultron in maybe like the past 200 games. He moves something. He has Onslaught. We should be good here. Bye-bye. This deck is dirty, though. This deck will do you straight dirty. The nerf to Angela has been fucking me up, though. That one power actually means quite a bit. Back to 99. We need 7 cubes. 7 whole cubes. I think we can do it. I really think we can do it with this absolutely degenerate deck. Good, good, good. We got a 1, 2, 3. Ooh, we got a bar sinister. Okay, I think this time I'm going to do it right. This time for sure. Mojo is also really good on bar sinister. So this whole deck is just really good because of bar sinister. Oh, weird world. That's a little weird. We probably just play Mojo mid. Hello, Muffin. Yes, you've come to see the degenerate deck. Get up on the desk. Sit down. Okay. The real question is, what happens now? I flip first, which means I am in the clear. We move all of these out of the way, and we Green Goblin. He might play something there, but it doesn't matter because I go first. That would mean, I think, 2 Green Goblins stay on my side, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, I could have Nightcrawler. I could have kept 1 Nightcrawler there. Ooh, that was actually a mistake. Because I'm pretty sure I can keep 1 Nightcrawler here, and 4 still go over. Because the first one, and then 3 get copied, and then those 3 jump over. That was my bad, Chief. I haven't played too much with the Bar Sinister combo. Honestly, though, I had a lot of people play this against me, and I would literally rage quit. I would also... I had, like, Cosmo, I had Mojo, I was playing different decks. And on turn 3, I would Cosmo Bar Sinister. Just because, literally, like, every other game, this would happen to me. And like, what is he supposed to do now? How does he beat me? Is the real question. I could debris. I get 3. Can he beat me if I debris right now? I mean, he could play something. Actually, I don't think he could beat me. I feel like he's going to play one thing here, and then I debris. And we have Mojo. I actually think I win right here, right now. Oh, I could Ant-Man. Okay. That seems more like it. 1 cube at a time, baby. Yeah, it's gonna be hard to get more than one cube when that happens. Because, like, you see that, your opponent sees that, and you kind of just want to retreat immediately. Some people snap on turn three if Bar Sinister's open. That probably means that they have a Green Goblin. He's got a green card back, Green Goblin. Oh, if you're playing Iceman Scorpion means they're playing Green Goblin. It's just irrefutable facts. This is also really bad for me. He's snapping already? Honestly, I don't care. I'm leaving. Honestly, fuck you. I hate Iceman. Iceman on kamar-taj just is so annoying. Iceman in general is really annoying. It's probably one of the strongest one costs. Just because of the sheer disruption it puts into the opponent's hand. I suppose this deck that I'm playing could easily run Iceman. I suppose Iceman instead of Nightcrawler, or you could just remove something else to get Iceman in. Nightcrawler is a really good card. You could remove, like, I don't think you need Jessica Jones. But I think that's the only other four other than Shang-Chi. So your four slot is a little weird, but you run a couple twos, so you could, like, do double two. Interesting. Interesting. This is a easy Angela. Oh, and I flip first. He's fucked. You're boned. We don't snap, though, because then he just retreats. I mean, we'll see what he's doing as well. I guess I could snap. Maybe I sneak away with it. What? He might retreat, though. This has happened quite a bit. What do you do? Do you let it go through, bub? Let it go through. I know you want to. And then, like, after we hit Bar Sinister, we can hit Hobgoblin somewhere. Oh, it's so nasty. And he let it go through. That's a free two cubes. Yeah, this is not okay. This should be illegal. It's like, what is my man supposed to do? Oh my god, and I have debris. Debris is 1, 2, 3. He could play one thing on Nidvalur. I kind of don't like that, though. I've played debris on Bar Sinister a lot, and I get absolutely fucked on. Especially if I... Is that honestly pretty good? Honestly, it's really good, because it's only 3, so I only get 3 here, 3 here. Oh, wait, no. But I can't play anything there next turn. I think I'm going to armor. Give up on Kiln. We played 2 things there, too. I don't know what he had, but clearly he was not okay with it. If we can keep sneaking away the 2 cubes, infinite is right at our fingertips. I will be able to debris on Bar Sinister and it work one of these times. One of these times. Wait, didn't I just play this guy? He knows what I'm doing. Got hood, okay. Armor's really good here. We do flip first. Honestly, I'm okay with it. I think I snap too. Just because I know he wants to get rid of hood, and he will not be able to. He probably plays like Bucky Barnes here as well. Armor's actually a really, really good card. I underestimated armor quite heavily when I first started playing. Oh, I just realized that Lemuria kind of fucks that up. He's playing hood. The real question is, do I mojo here? Mojoing there seems really weird. Honestly, I think it's okay, because mojo would be 8 times 4, 40 power. Honestly, I'm going to mojo here. It's a little awkward, but okay. He actually didn't play anything at all. Okay. I think that's a JJ. And we're going to take over Lemuria with Shang-Chi. I won't be able to Shang-Chi on Stark Tower. But I mean, this is 40 power if he ever puts something on Bar Sinister. Is that right? 6? Oh, no, no, no. That's 8 times 5. This is 8 times 4. Just 32. 32 power is still very good. E snapped? Oh, that makes me a bit nervous. What you got here, bud? She-Hulk, that's why he didn't play anything. I see. Hmm. 10 power is more than 8 power, believe it or not. Angela. I suppose I storm. I could just Angela here to get the last 2 power. Could also, oh no, I can't Angela there. My Nightcrawler is there. Could storm. Not that it really matters. I guess I Angela storm. Deathlock. Okay. Yondu. There was my Green Goblin. Nova. So I'm assuming that he has Killmonger. All systems go. Hmm. Blue Marvel does not do enough there. I mean, it's honestly looking like a Doctor Doom. Because if he does Killmonger this, he only gets 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Doctor Doom is 5. That is 1 more than 4. This is 5, 6, 7. That'll be 11. He hasn't destroyed anything. He can't play death. I think we're fine. I really hope I don't lose 8 cubes here. Bucky, Carnage. Oh, fuck. Was that enough? No! Oh, that's so sad. You know, I thought he was going to do Killmonger for some reason. Shang-Chi doesn't win that either. I can't move Nightcrawler either. That's rough. Well, back to square one. That's what I get for being greedy. I just thought, like, oh, dude, there's no way. There's no way anyone beats me, right? She-Hulk, I think, is one of the strongest cards in the game. I don't understand how they thought that card was okay. Like, ever. That card is literally absurd. Both Angela. Got the Bar Sinister. God damn it. And I didn't get it. Okay, we definitely don't mojo. Not again. Maybe I just storm here. Storm JJ. Interesting. So he's also running debris. Looks like we're running pretty similar decks. I just really hope he doesn't have Green Goblin. I'm thinking we can win flooding. Maximus. Ooh, see, now the big thing here is on five. On five, it's pretty likely that they play something on Bar Sinister. I think we go for it anyways. Oh, fuck. We retreated! What? Wait. Why? I will take it. I'm pretty sure he would have just won there, like, straight up. Oh, wait. What if he also played Hobgoblin? Wait a second. He also played Hobgoblin, so he was just like, oh, dude, well, he played something there, so I lose. No, not the Iceman. I don't know why he retreated, but that was funny. We got a kiln. Yeah, probably armor. Mini lab. Can't even play anything. Awful. Definitely JJ here. He didn't play anything. Don't you dare play She-Hulk. Don't fucking do it. Card's way too strong. Zone JJ. That won't help you here, boy. Probably Hobgob. We could Blue Marvel Doctor Doom, which is also pretty good. I think Hobgoblin is a little bit better. Watch him also play Hobgoblin. No, he played DD. Wait, this is also DD. I didn't think about that. How to win? I mean, we probably give up there. Do we? I wish I had Shang-Chi in my hand. Unfortunately, I don't. There's no way I can win by playing Doctor Doom there. Because I move it over, we do this here. Seven? That's only seven power. That's pretty damn bad. I feel like that's so bad. I really wish I had Shang-Chi. I feel like we lose here. Why is his own Doctor Doom? You idiot. Everyone knows my Doctor Doom is better. Clearly just superior. Okay, back to 99. we're back to where we started, 30 minutes in. Dude, that's a problem when you win like one cube a game and then you lose eight. You literally just worked all of that progress gone in an instant. What do you got, big boy? Agent 13. Also makes me think Devil Dinosaur. I don't really want to put armor here because I feel like Shang-Chi is going to be pretty good there. Honestly, I probably play nothing here. Probably play nothing and then Shang-Chi at last turn. That'll probably do me pretty well. Lemuria. We got a Mojo. It's turn three, I didn't realize. Yeah, let's get Mojo here. There's the green gobble. Yeah, we JJ. I just want him to buff up Stark Tower and then I Shang-Chi it. That's all I want to happen. I guess I could put Green Goblin somewhere maybe. This is four. big tears. That was me when I lost the 8 cubes. Okay, dude, it doesn't take that long, okay? Turn 4, there shouldn't be that many decisions that you have. Like, I can understand a turn 6, you know, taking a few years, but... Turn 4? Playing Moon Knight? Where did he get this? Oh, Agent 13. Oh, I don't like that. I don't like that one bit. This puts a wrench into my plans. Good debris. I kind of want a debris here because maybe he doesn't put something there on this turn. I mean, it will get plus 2 from the rock. Can you smell what the rock is cooking? Yeah, we'll just put it here. Man, I should have done it. Oh, that's looking like a Shang-Chi target if I've ever seen one. All systems go. Does he flip first? He does. How does he only have 3 cards in his hand? That doesn't even win. Wait, that doesn't even win. Oh, wait, I can do this and move Nightcrawler. I mean, he's going to play something on Stark Tower. Like, there's no way he doesn't. Like, Moon Girl? I'm feeling Moon Girl. It's up in the air, but I think we do this. Give yourself a card back. Thank you, Jesus. He wins by not playing Moon Girl, which is really funny. Gets him every time. Yeah, debris is a really nice addition into the deck just to try to fill out some of their other spaces. Like, then you can really pinpoint where they're going to play. It's very, very good to have. Give me Green Goblin. Do it to me. Me likey. Me likey a lot. Don't do it. Okay, JJ is fine. Ew. Ew. Can't play anything. Goose. Oh, dude. He's goose control. My goose is cooked. Easy fat Green Goblin here. He flips first, so I might be absolutely fucked. But through JJ, like, you don't know I'm playing Green Goblin. Oh, he's Cerebro 2. Or he could be Cerebro 3. Could be Cerebro 3. He's about to be Cerebro negative 3. You can't play Hobgoblin on Kamar-taj either. It jumps over and then jumps back, which is kind of funny. 4. Now, this debris is kind of funny as well. Yes. But of course, give me that cube. Come on. Come on, within the hour. Within the hour, I should be able to do it. I just need to play safe. If I feel like I'm going to lose, I need to retreat. I don't want a Dr. Doom. Dr. Doom seems kind of weird. I think I'm just going to Blue Marvel turn 1. Morbin? Wrong guy. Ooh, discard strong guy. I've got Shang-Chi here, which means probably just going to do that there. Let's go ahead. I think we should get... No, I'll get Angela here. I can't play armor there, of course. Ooh, Wolverine. Really? I didn't think people played Wolverine. Ooh, Bar Sinister. Hello. Nightcrawler is pretty good, I think. pretty good. No, because Blue Marvel is here. I think I'm just gonna do this. Another Goose player. Armor might be bad because this Morbius could get over 9 power. I don't see it happening, but it could. There's the Hobgob. I can't do anything this turn. That's unfortunate. Swordmaster? He's about to discard his whole hand. Oh, he only has one more card. Oh, never mind. How does he ever expect to get everything out of his hand for Strong Guy? JJ does actually win there. Because that's 8. We've done this math before. That's 32. Oh, it's actually more because of Blue Marvel. How's he gonna play everything? He won't be able to activate Strong Guy. Ooh, Black Cat. He flips first. He's got 4 cards in his hand. He literally can't activate Strong Guy. What the hell? I mean, I can Doctor... Oh, I was about to say I can Doctor Doom. I can't because of Goose. We would tie here on Shadowland if I Doctor Doom there. I definitely don't want a Hobgoblin. That's just bad. Oh, actually, we don't tie. What does he have? What does he have? There's no way he can beat me, right? He's got the 3 Swarm in his hand, and then he just has whatever the fuck else. Like, just the top deck. I think we win, unless he has Hela. No, because he didn't discard, like, that many good things. Hela's not that good. He has no Apoc. He can't play everything. I'm assuming this is a win. I would definitely feel like this is a win. Because he'll win Project Pegasus. Exactly, the one extra power that I get from Blue Marvel. Bro, calculations. I know how to calculate. Oh, we're so close. 3 cubes. 3. Please, okay. I just need to chill out, do my math, and we'll be good. Oh, we have a green gob in hand. Notice that we haven't hobgobbed very much. It is a little bit harder to play, all things considered. What does he have there? He's got a lizard. He does flip first, which does... Ooh. Ew, my green goblin is -1. I actually don't like him snapping. So he snaps. He probably has green goblin then. The problem with that is that I can't really play anything. I mean, his green goblin's going to be -1 as well, right? Actually, Storm here is probably, like, okay. Oh, he didn't have it. Okay. That was a little weird. My bad. So I guess we're gonna give up Kiln, and we'll go for these two. I really thought he was gonna play Green Goblin there. When most people snap on turn 3, maybe he wanted me to think he had Green Goblin, and then I was just gonna retreat and he gets a free cube. Which is definitely a possibility. Now we have to think, Blue Marvel or Hobgob next turn? Ooh, it's probably going to be Blue Marvel. Punisher. Punisher, I barely know her. I'm sorry. I like Blue Marvel, I think. Blue Marvel, Doctor Doom. Because I have a sneaking suspicion he's going to... Well, actually, there's no way he plays his last card. He can only play something here. There's actually no way. Right? Yeah, that's right. That's right. He has to retreat. There's no way he beats me. Wait, actually? Wait a second. This is 7. Yeah. Oh, wait, no, his Punisher gets 1. His Punisher gets 1. That should be fine, though, right? His Punisher gets 1, 7. This will be 7. This will be 17. This will be 5. I should win on the tie. Honestly, I shouldn't snap here. Okay. Yes, I should. I guess I could have just ended turn. I would have gotten the 4 cubes. I mean, in that moment, you should probably just retreat no matter what. But I don't know. Maybe he's insane. So we need 1 cube. 1. We don't snap. We don't do anything. If I feel even the slightest tingle on my balls, I'm retreating. Because honestly, I shouldn't have snapped in that last game. That was just negligent. I'm too drunk on the power of hobbing on my gob. Don't do this to me. Okay. Atlantis. That's really good if I can green gob here. If this isn't Bar Sinister, green gob, Atlantis, or hobgob it. I hope this is Bar Sinister and he just gets fucked on. No, Dream Dimension. Ew. Actually, this is amazing. We don't snap. We are non-snappers. I'm going to tell him I'm confident now, though. Just so he knows. You played your juice in the wrong squeeze. Why would you play Green Goblin there? These are the real fucking questions, dude. Why would you do that? Honestly, Storm here is pretty good. Well, it might fuck him up. No, let's do it, because if I do draw Blue Marvel, then Well. That's a little weird. I have Dr. Diddle Doom. I can't play Hobgob there. Best I can do is play it there. I could Mojo Armor as well. Mojo Armor. I still won't get the... Wait, can I Mojo Armor here? That's not enough, is it? That's 8, 9, 10, 11. Wait, this is neg 1, so 7, 10. That's actually more power than I thought. Actually, we can Mojo here, armor here. Oh, wait, he has Nightcrawler. Dude, I am smoking crack. Wait, is that still enough? What? This will be plus 6? That's 7 plus 5? Oh no, 7 plus 5 is 12. And Shang-Chi sucks. I mean, I could Dr. Doom anyways, because maybe he doesn't win on Citadel. Like, he probably just plays like ones here. And they get beef. I'm gonna retreat. I don't like this. I think we can have a better game. No point in losing two cubes. I'm not confident in that game. This looks good. Good curve. We got Bar Sinister immediately. Ooh, and we have the Nightcrawler. I think I'm gonna do it. That is protection. So I highly doubt that he will Green Goblin me as I have all of my Nightcrawlers here. Oh, that's interesting. Definitely Angela. This time I can move three Nightcrawlers and play Green Goblin. Do it right this time. This guy's infinite. He's got hood. I could armor as well. Ew. Ew, I don't like that. Let's do this. What does he do? I flip first at least, so there's that. I mean, he can move his four Green Goblins to New York, but do you? A lot of space that you're losing. Also, Strange Academy. And see, now we have the perfect amount here. I can move this Nightcrawler away at any time. I'm guessing that he like carnages here, like Bucky Carnage. Wait, no. Oh, Deadpool Carnage. Interesting. Well, I have Shang-Chi. That's very nice. I mean, I could just JJ there. Yeah, that's probably fine. Probably fine, right? Do I keep this Nightcrawler? That's probably fine to keep the Nightcrawler there, too, if you think about it. What are you playing now there? Deadpool Venom. Oh. Oh. Don't I just Shang-Chi him? I think I do. I Shang-Chi. This is like an easy Shang-Chi here. He honestly doesn't have a lot on his board. What three things did he play now? How does he have so many things to play? Oh, that's nasty. Don't put it here. Thank you. We can only move two. I can move two. And then I can Dr. Doom. I like how this Angela is at zero power still. He snapped. He moves two. I guess he can get rid of what's on. Like, he can move these two and then he can destroy it with... He doesn't have Carnage anymore. He doesn't have Venom. Well, honestly, Venom wouldn't be good. What else can destroy? He already played Killmonger. Dude, you don't win, do you? I'd be very surprised if he beat me. No, he didn't move anything. Does he have his own Shang-Chi or something? Wait, no, it doesn't even kill anything mid. Dude, if I lose eight cubes here, I am going to... eat my own ass. Thank you. Okay, that Taskmaster was a little scary. We did it! We fucking did it. This is infinite, right? Oh, yes! We've done it! Finally. Oh my god. I have waited so long. I have played so many hours a day to get this stupid ass card back, to make it into infinite. And we do it with the scummiest deck alive. Gobble all over my deck. Yep, you heard that right. So, it's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Notice how in like the past, or in like those last like four games, we never saw debris. We never saw debris. And I think very few times did we actually see Blue Marvel. But this was the deck. A lot of fun. It is a lot of fun. However, you will go to hell after playing this. So if you don't have some of these cards, they can definitely be replaced for stuff. Like I said, you could definitely get Iceman in here. You can get Scorpion. Just more disruption, honestly. I bet Arrow is really good in this deck. But that'll be it for me. Thank you so much for watching. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed. And you know what? Have a wonderful day.